Yeah, damn, man. Music in the Bottle podcast.
My little young ass. I was in the ninth grade trying to put a finger in a waistband. Acting a nut.
I was just trying to get sex back. Finger in the waistband. That's traction.
That's big traction. That's big moves.
I didn't know, man.
That's big moves. That's like a pre-approval.
Is it?
It's big moves.
Yeah.
That's like an appraisal. It's almost got an inspection right there.
Yeah, 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 I could say.
You was trying to get a text back. I was trying to get somebody to talk back to me.
Nah. I was trying to get some underwriting. You know what I mean?
Around this time, a nigga braces came off.
Oh, really?
It was over. Man. I was so far gone.
I did not need braces up top, but I did need them on my the lower unit.
Yeah.
I never got them, so I fixed my smile, so I don't know.
Not you adjusted the smile. Niggas is, hey, niggas different. You know what I'm saying? We're some wheelless away and shit. I'm going to figure it out.
Aha. Uh-huh. Science.
Yo. Yes, y'all niggas getting veneers when we get that big bucks? How y'all playing it?
I could. I want to.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Just fuck it. Get some veneers. Yeah. What they about, 10K, 15? I've been seeing niggas get the low work. I think mid-rank. Yeah, right. I didn't see niggas get the low work.
I had the money for it. I get it right now.
Yeah. What the fuck you talking about?
My nigga. I mean.
My niggas come through shit pearly. Shit crazy. Niggas look like they got the vampire teeth in.
Yeah, for sure.
Nah, I see it.
I know.
I like it.
I know. Yeah.
Nah, look.
Mm-hmm.
As long as they don't saw my shit down, I had a shark teeth. I can't fuck with that. That's what I'm scared
I think,
of.
I don't know if I could, bro. Like, cause I'd
that's
be
nervous.
Like under the veneers, knowing that I got the nah, yeah, I can't do that, bro. I'll keep these.
You know what I'm saying? My shit cool.
Yeah, I'm
good. You
know what
I'm saying? And that's why I feel like the veneers is for like the weird shaped teeth niggas. Like when you got like, you know what I'm saying? When your teeth just like them bitches malfunctioned at some point. I don't know what happened to them. Like, I think then you need them, but like,
yeah.
You know, other than that, bro, you look. We just gonna we get some Invisalign. Throw braces on.
I think the braces work great, man. I mean, I see no reason why you shouldn't do those. I'm gonna talk on the mic real quick, but yeah, I see no reason why you can't just go that route. But some people don't have the patience, man.
No, that's a fact.
Braces take patience. You know what I mean?
I was supposed to get them growing up. Yeah. Again, it just didn't happen.
Patience. That's how it be. It's patience, man. You know,
that's how it be.
Because you knew you was gonna be in the limelight to get veneers.
Yeah.
So why not?
No.
Mm.
You believed in yourself before anybody did.
Yeah.
Got to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Got to.
I'm just going to get all golds, honestly. That's why I'm not going to get mine.
Trinidad James gold?
You get all golds.
Trinidad.
You should.
Kodak.
All gold, everything.
Yeah, no, that's the logo for the Matthews group now. Just like your gold tooth smile.
Go buy a zip weed. For like 10 niggas to get in. Have me drunk.
Lit
in this bitch.
Yeah, no, facts.
I think we all blessed. We don't need veneers. So yeah, we all
man,
good
we
here.
We pearly, man. We pearly.
Music in a Bottle podcast floss.
Now we selling floss.
You're not kicking off like this.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Hey, what's going on? It's Music in a Bottle podcast, man. My name is Music in a Bottle podcast. I'm here with a few great guys.
My name is
ham
sandwich. This is episode 125.
Five, 125,
and alive, man.
Yeah,
it's time
man.
To thrive
with the guys.
Hard to survive. Come on, man.
Nah, man.
Don't at me.
Nah,
bro.
Look,
I'm
we
here.
Can get it. You know what I'm saying?
Like, you know what I mean? I'm here.
I'm ready, man.
Yeah, it's easy today, man.
Yeah, we getting the freestyles back up, man.
Oh yeah, for sure. We're gonna pick it up, man. In the building with me, I got Mark Man the Shooter. For sure. Is Mark Man the Shooter, who is dressed identical to what Jamele has on right now.
Yeah.
So just a heads up. I got Ranger Wayne, who's dropping mixtapes
like
this week. Big shout out to Big Kent, Wild Big Kent, Wild Boy, Ranger.
Big Light
Wayne, Ranger.
Mr. 313, man. Mr. 248, man. You already know what it is.
There you go.
Don't
talk
get hurt,
it.
Man. Grand Valley's very own. The leader of the Alphas.
Hey. Yeah. Bow, bow, bow. Talk that shit.
Bow, bow. For sure. Mr. Got it in the trunk.
My cannon.
Speaking of the trunk, you got them bricks for me, Wayne?
Damn, that's crazy. That's crazy. Because we got to talk about it after. Just know I don't have the bricks anymore. Just don't have them anymore.
See,
God damn it.
That leads to both. Y'all both letting each other down this week.
Yeah,
man. Oh, man. And I got the man himself, man. Corked up. Jamele. Cabernet J.
Cab J.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Midrange.
We here.
Yes, sir.
In the building, man. Yes, beanie and all, man. You know
lethal
what I mean?
Lethal midrange.
Lethal midrange.
Lethal midrange.
Crazy stop on a fast break. You thought I was dragging two more steps, dummy.
Nope.
Are you dumb?
Stupid.
Stop.
Cabernet J. Mr. 517's in the building, man.
Yeah, man.
Sorry.
My name's Darryl Matthews. I saw houses.
Big Pie Mahomes and his big
pop.
You know what I'm saying?
Man, we here.
Mahomes.
Your favorite Potter's favorite Potter.
Headed back to the Super Bowl.
Back in the Super Bowl.
Ankle still fucked up.
It's a controversial late hit, but you know, we ain't going to talk about that.
Yeah.
You know, but you there.
He pushed me. You crazy? Push me. You can't touch this. This is merchandise. This is 500 mil.
Hey,
you get me? Push me into the bench. You pushed me. Were we past the line?
No.
Were we
about to say it was clean. It was clean.
Dwayne.
It was clean. It was clean. I can't even say it was controversial. It was clean.
I know.
Yes. That was a clean one.
He pushed me. Did you see his teammate though? Why you had to push him?
Why you push the quarterback?
You weren't even in a game.
Yeah.
What are you talking about? Yeah. Pussy.
Sorry. It's your fourth year. You play five games.
Get some playing time first before you start talking.
That's what I would say. Fight me.
Yeah, at that point.
At that point, fight me.
And the season's over.
Season's
so
over.
Like, yeah. Why not? Mm-hmm. We here now.
What yeah. Because I'm already off the team. I didn't cost us a Super Bowl.
Yeah. Yeah. They getting rid of me. For sure.
It's all right.
I'm taking an extended vacation.
Man, how y'all weeks been?
Man, this week been straight so far, man. Again, it's only Tuesday, but last week, you know, went to go play beer pong. It was like Wednesday and.
What happened?
My bad, Ranger.
That's all good, bro.
That's really my
you're bad for what?
It's okay, bro. We don't even got to do that. You don't even have to
that's really
that.
My
do
bad.
What? No one knows.
That's right, bro.
But just know.
No one knows.
It's all right.
But just know. It ain't going to happen again, Ranger.
All right, man. That's all
what
I need,
did,
man.
I mean, just
that's all I need is a guarantee, bro.
Just for the people that didn't, I mean, don't know. What happened?
Man, just know, you know, I know y'all been following our ping pong journey.
Oh, yeah.
Your pong journey.
Uh-huh. Ping pong.
You know, beer pong. So I did my pregame, you know what I'm saying? You know, my pregame ritual is, you know, I go to the bar and get a little loose, you know what I'm saying, before my guy hit me after work, you know what I'm saying? So I'm at the bar chilling, chopping it with the locals, you know, kicking it with my friends.
Fans.
And, and you know, I text my guy that text, like, yo, we lit.
Who's
you
your
know
guy?
What I'm saying?
Just out of curiosity.
Jamele.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Jay, so, you know. Yeah, Jamele favorite. And so, you know, I was waiting on a response, you know, and you know it didn't come through, and I'm like, you know, it's cool. I'll probably meet him there. You know what I'm saying?
Maybe just gonna pop up his phone.
You know,
day.
You
no
know
service.
How my guy is. Yeah, he's probably there already.
Cause he got a Lansing number.
Yeah,
he ain't growing
nah,
up a lot.
So. He warming up. He low key on his fourth game when I pull up.
Cause he ain't in down pull south up. No more. He 10 minutes away.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
I pull up. You know, he's looking real male-less in there. You know, and so. Yeah. I'm like, all right, maybe he gonna slide. Just put the name down. You know, he ain't here yet, so I was just like, I didn't even put the music.
Oh, so
in the
you
bottom
reserved
name.
Him a spot.
I still wrote it
in
down.
Our name.
You know,
in
I ain't even use our name because I'm like, you know, he ain't here. If I gotta play with a,
it ain't our name.
If
it
I
ain't
gotta
our
play,
ball.
If I gotta play with a lefty, you know what I'm saying. If I gotta play with somebody else, I can't put the name down. That's you know crazy. What I'm saying. So yeah, I put down some other shit. Yeah. You know what I'm saying. I think I actually put down some other shit. You know, just out of spite. You know, and then my guy ain't pull up. I had to play with the With the fourth string quarterback looking like 49ers out there.
Oh, wow.
Needless to say, we sat that nigga down quick.
So you went from a ball guy to a dude with dreads.
Needless to say, we sat that nigga down quick, I'll tell you that.
Yeah.
And we just got on the bottom there.
Do a couple picks.
Yeah, we just got on the bottom there.
It won't happen again.
They tried to have us in the rebuttal game. I said, yo, y'all trying to go to the next spot, you know? And
oh, so you exited.
Oh, I left. There was no need to play the second game.
So it sounds like, I mean, just to wrap this up, synopsis.
I mean, it's simple.
Feel free to say I don't know what you would say right now, but it sounds like to
it's
me.
It's on me, man. It's on me.
It's okay, bro. You took a nap.
Take the blame.
And it was a little heavy nap. You didn't wake up to the morning.
It's all right.
I mean, it was.
Did you still go to Tin Can in the morning?
It was just about, because I think
for
I texted Wayne at like 2:30.
It was like 2 a.m. It was like 2 a.m. type shit.
Y'all
mind
out?
You, I was still out. I was still out.
It's a Thursday. It's a Wednesday.
It's a Wednesday.
There in Grand Rapids, not
still,
Miami.
Yeah, I'm still out. It's fuego,
God,
night.
Lee,
Papi it fuego
Chulo.
Night. It's fuego night.
Papi Chulo.
It's fuego night.
Papi Chulo. Yeah, I know.
Yeah. Get me out there at fuego night, man.
Yeah.
I was in
again,
there.
It won't happen
Chata
again.
Till 2 a.m.
You said you had the banchata on you?
Oh, but no, man. So that was lit. Shout out to Steve over at Muse. They had the
big shout out, yeah.
Unveilings of two exhibits he put on. They both was dope. One of them's at Grand Valley, which is super tight, and then one was at Muse GR.
That's what's up.
That was Thursday and Friday. Fridays or Saturday it snowed. One of them days it snowed hard as fuck.
Both, kinda.
Yeah,
all day Saturday.
Yeah, all day Saturday. Yeah. Friday was nasty.
Like Thursday through Saturday.
Sure.
Yeah.
It was pretty bad.
And then so Saturday, I really just chill. I ended up watching You People, that movie. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. On Netflix, so I watched that.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, we can probably talk about that shit later. I got some things to say.
Don't a bag. But yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, so, and you know, following that, yeah, bro, shit, kicked off the week, man. Week's been cool so far. Blessed and highly favored. One thing I will say is niggas just got to keep their heads up, man. Definitely, I fell in a space where, like, mentally, I'm like, I get paranoid quick. I overthink. So when shit's going good, I'm thinking about when it's going to go bad. Mm. 9 times out of 10. Even if it's positive. And sometimes it's in good faith, right? Like, yeah, you got business and shit is good. How do we keep it good? You know? Amen. And so it's a similar concept. But, you know, just kind of, yes, while it is always good to prepare and be prepared and, you know, kind of have that mindset, always remember to worry free, though. You know, the Lord doesn't want you worrying. You know, that's what he died on the cross for. So, get the worries out the way and just, you know, focus on what you got to do every day to make sure you live in your life the way you're supposed to. So, 100%.
Agreed, man. I like that a lot. This too shall pass, though. Factual. You know what I mean?
Say it right
good
there.
Good time, bad time.
That's all it is. And it did. I woke up today and shit was literally everything I was worried about switched left crazy. So it's just like, that's just to show you. Keep the faith. Always. Yeah.
Amen.
100%.
Jay?
My grandma used to always say, what'd she say? She used to say, the Lord won't put more on than you can't handle. So I've been kind of living by like that too. So
that's real.
Whenever things do get bad, it's like, okay, like I'm meant to handle this or go through this.
For a reason.
For a reason. Yeah.
Seasons for a reason.
So, yeah.
There you go.
But my week, what's been up?
What you been on?
Man, the weather this weekend was crappy as hell. I'm
nasty.
Mad about it. And it was like single digit temps past couple days. But did some wine stuff this weekend. Poured some wine in Cedar Springs. That was a vibe. Owners came through.
What's like the biggest takeaway from that?
Honestly, just seeing. So being with the company since beginning of 2021, obviously I went to Napa for a bit, but to come back and like see the growth that the company has had, and just seeing like, even though this was just posted on social media, but people really came out like, hey, like we came to the winery back, you know, way back when, but you're one of our favorite wineries out there. So just to hear like the respect and like the growth of the winery, obviously, you know, I've played some part in that too. So it's just excited to just kind of go places and people come because they enjoy the wine or they're already club members and it's closer for them to get to this event versus going back out to the winery. So they're supporting regardless. So it's just been cool to see the growth, honestly. Super happy to be a part of the growth too. Katie and I slid to the east side of the state. So stayed with the in-laws Saturday night.
Okay.
After the event, had an event at the Royce Detroit. Shout out to the Royce.
Shout out to the Royce.
Another Modales event featuring Southwest Michigan wine. So this was the first time that I felt like Southwest Michigan got love. Like usually when it's Michigan wines, it's always up north or you hear about Traverse City or stuff from up north. It's never stuff on the south side or the southwest side, essentially.
Yeah.
So to be at an event featuring all wines from the southwest side of the state was super cool. I feel like we don't get enough love, but shout out to Royce for the support of Michigan wine in general, but of course Southwest Michigan. So kicked it with some cool winemakers and some cool peeps in Detroit.
Okay.
Met some cool people as well. Some Roof Fund scholars for the first, or met scholars for the first time that live in the Detroit area.
Okay.
So that was super dope. And yeah, for me, it honestly was the first time I really felt like, obviously I've been a part of the Michigan wine industry since I started at Modales. But, like, to really be at an event and, like, kind of have some say or, like, people knew who I was, like, in this industry was super cool.
That's what's up.
So, like I said, super cool event. Glad it was at the Royce. And just, like I said, just felt like, yo, I really work full-time in wine. That's crazy. But,
that boy.
Here we are.
There it is.
But, yeah, it was a good week. Like I said, we got to kick it with the in-laws. Got to see wifey's grandma. My grandma now. So got to hang out with some family. And then wifey's also watching BMF. So we took the long way to Detroit. We went through E-Course and
River. I had to see it. Y'all wanted to see it, huh?
That's where Rain was at.
I know it wasn't.
You know, we took the scenic, not scenic route.
No, I get you. Yeah. Y'all stopped by that Coney and shit too. Y'all want to see the whole thing.
No, we just went straight.
Just straight through, huh? Just don't even stop at a stoplight. Just keep
straight
going.
Through, made a little curve, hit Fort, straight to Detroit.
There you go. I like
that's crazy.
It.
Yeah, BMF. That was my weekend in a nutshell, though.
They've been going off on BMF.
I like it.
I ain't seen the last episode yet, though.
I ain't seen the last episode yet, either. I'll probably watch it after this. I ain't gonna
care. Yeah, same here. Same here, bro. I will after this. I've been watching The Last of Us like crazy. It's a great show.
I got two or three episodes.
Three.
Okay.
It's the coldest show I've seen this year.
I got to watch it, man. Is it scary, though? See? Nah, nigga, I'm cool.
No.
Is it like Resident Evil type?
Yeah. I mean, like, it ain't scary. Okay. Ain't nothing scary about it. Like, I mean, it's...
Because I ain't the thriller ass.
You watched Walking Dead, didn't you?
Yeah, I watched Walking Dead. Oh, yeah. It's like, okay. All right, we cool.
Walking Dead had, what, three scenes where you like, dang.
Yeah.
Maybe. Do you still watch Walking Dead, though?
Nah, hell no.
Is it still on?
Yeah.
Yeah, because they got, like, spinoffs of it, don't they?
I think so.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, one of like, those was kind of straight, though, yeah.
But it's, like, the same title. It'd be, like, The City of the Walking Dead. It's like, nigga, you can just keep the show going.
Didn't you guys do that with Power?
Yeah, no, that was different, though.
Real different.
I am watching The Boys, though, and that shit's crazy.
Oh, you started it?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm on, like, season two now.
Oh, wow.
The Boys is nuts.
Moving.
That's a good-ass show. That's a good-ass show, man. I like The Boys a lot.
Yeah, I might have to check that out, man.
I just seen, too, like, recently they surpassed, the views of The Boys surpassed Marvel, all of the Marvel shows.
Oh, wow.
This is the most watched superhero show ever.
Some of the Marvel shows, I ain't gonna lie, like, I haven't watched, honestly, maybe one of them.
Yeah.
I haven't watched, but.
Yeah, they outbeat them though, but I can see why. Like as a show, just because it's not surrounded by like superheroes and villains precisely, it tells a unique story of it. It's still very like, even though it's talking about superheroes, it's very realistic.
Got it.
And I think that's something that you can gravitate to from different aspects of the show.
Agreed.
It's dope. But D, tell us about your week, bro.
What? Shout out to Lil Durk. But music wise, man, I've been on a Jersey Club kick. So once that song got cut by Brent Faiyaz, that All Mine remix.
Yeah.
I've been on that. Yeah. It's fire. Like their music is fire. That whole culture is fire. And I just did a bunch of research on it. And like that's a whole section of music that like I never have been exposed to. So like you see a little bit of that in I think Chicago and the way that they dance. But like Jersey got their whole vibe. Yeah. For real, which is super dope.
That's dope.
In terms of...
You about to start doing legit and walking. Like, you about to get your little shit together, your footwork and shit now?
Oh, sounds like I need to consult the DJ on what to play at his own party, so maybe I will be.
Oh, my.
See, you never didn't think I'd take it there, but we're here now.
Go ahead, man. No, it's been a show week, bro. Talk about your week.
I'm ready. I'm teed up.
Jesus.
I'm teed up. I'm ready. But with that being said, man, I had... a decent week, man. We have a lot of learning lessons. I think that you have to have more meetings, but meetings don't have to be 30 minutes.
Facts.
So what if you had 10-minute meetings every 3 days versus 30-minute meeting one time a week?
I can see it.
So Monday, Wednesday, Friday, you have a 10-minute meeting versus having a 30-minute meeting on Monday. Makes a lot of sense, man. And we've broken that down a little bit, got a little bit more direct on what we're doing, and also giving people freedom to just go.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, we got some growth and whatnot that I'm a little afraid of. But what I will do, and I said this maybe a couple podcasts ago, is that it's a 360-degree turn on or 180-degree turn from where we were at January 2021.
Let's go.
2022 versus 2023. So
let's do
it. And it's the last day of the month, technically speaking. But we're into February now, so it's crazy. Yeah. For sure.
But I like it.
With that being said, man, week's been straight, bro. Love we it. Out here in the streets. In streets, I'm trying to do another streets. Building, trying to figure out how to get the up out of there. But yeah,
oh man,
we out here.
I like that talk.
Lions got four Pro Bowlers. I was a
Facts.
Winner. Yeah, shout out to Penei Sewell, Amon St. Brown,
JG,
and the first one to actually make it without reserves was Frank Ragnow. Frank Ragnow. Yeah,
I love it.
Love it. Otherwise, love man, it, what we it. Drinking on? What you sipping on?
I ain't even grab my bottle yet. Damn. I ain't gonna even lie.
Oh, I didn't even know.
I put it in the fridge for anyway.
See, that's love. No, it's good.
So next it's section good. Of the pod, we gonna get
you
to
know
it.
What I'm saying? We'll talk about it in the next one.
Let's Amen. Let's go.
You don't even know.
Not at this point.
1-2-1-2. Come.
Hey!
You don't know what the gun.
Come on, man. Nick was a terror in the backseat.
I'm the Hulk.
Yeah. Look at this. Smack Mark to the head 10 times and shit. Fucking with my dog, eating niggas treats.
Oh my gosh, dog. Man, I'm telling you. Yo, man. Shout out to DMX. Yo, he do got something though, for real.
Oh yeah. It's X.
He got some.
It's X.
Who did DMX go against in the verses? Rest in peace, man. That's sad. I can't think of DMX.
That's Snoop,
like that.
Right?
I think it was Snoop. It was Snoop in the studio.
That was a horrible versus. Like too different. Way too different.
Styles, you saying?
I don't know if Styles can win that one, bro.
I think it was like supposed to be like the battle of the dogs or something.
It was supposed to be battle of the dogs. Battle of dogs.
That's fair enough, bro. Should have had Bow Wow out there, huh?
This bro,
I said little by a while.
No, that's not it.
Hey, that shit used to have him rocking though.
It was,
yeah,
that shit did used to have him rocking,
man.
It wasn't that.
I had that album too.
Yep,
was Bow Wow to Drake before Drake?
No,
never.
Nah, no, Bow Wow was Soulja Boy though.
No, he wasn't.
He was Soulja Boy though.
Doing that.
I give him Soulja Boy.
We're definitely not doing that,
not even a little bit.
We are not.
Not even a
doing
tad.
That.
The only run I saw was Confessions Run by Usher. That might be a Drake-esque run. After I saw him in a Cadillac Escalade.
Oh. Boom, 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 boom. Hey.
After the night. Hey. Don't leave your girl around me. True player for real. That's my nigga. For real.
Hey.
Situation. Yeah, that was. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. Who had a run like that for real? Ludacris had a little run.
Celebration.
Did. Roll Out.
Hey.
Roll Out was my shit. I ain't gonna lie.
Hey, look. What's that shit?
Fetty Wap that too.
That shit that Luda dropped with the Austin Powers joint. I'm coming for the double one spot. Shit was a banger.
He got some. His music.
Get back.
Get back. Yeah. Luda don't get his flowers, man.
Get back, roll out.
His music aged like milk, though.
It did. That shit aged like sour cream.
Got a little sour.
And I hate to do this, but I do feel like his music is the same.
Sean who?
You know who you're talking
no,
about.
No, I don't. I want you to elaborate. There's a couple Seans out here.
Who are you talking about? Not Sean Paul.
No, I mean, you could be talking about Sean Carter.
No, not Sean John, Sean Carter. No.
Who are you talking about?
I thought my guy was safe, bro. He's
not Sean Marion. I mean, The Matrix. That movie's still going.
I know you're not talking about. I know you're talking about Big.
Huh? No, not the Notorious B.I.G. Come on,
I hear you,
Darryl.
What, man? We
it's
here.
2023, man.
What, man?
You still on his ass? And you still on his ass?
Let my man live.
Can we not hold our people accountable?
What you want them accountable for?
It didn't age well.
You got platinum tracks.
What didn't age well? His music in general.
Ass. Period.
The song Ass?
Yeah. It's a big one.
You saying a big one like that's his only big one?
No, it's not his only big one. Like, One Man Can't Change the World, that aged very well. I could listen to that today. But can you really go back to Finally Famous and say?
I have. Yeah. And it's good. Finally Famous is still good.
Got the vinyl.
I'm just saying
that. The album is nice.
I'm saying that it ages like Luda's music. That's all that I said.
No, you're not about to do that.
I wouldn't say that.
Because I say Luda is a singles creator. He makes good singles.
Yeah.
Niggas don't know no B-sides of Luda's.
You know, niggas don't know B-sides of Sean either.
Oh.
Respectfully.
God.
Respectfully.
No, I would say no. No.
Respect. I will die on this.
Bro,
so. Come on.
Hold on.
Go ahead. 313.
All I'm saying is, let's look at like Sean and singles. Sean probably has like, what, maybe two singles an album? Maybe three.
Two singles on an album.
Maybe three with 16 songs on his albums, 15 songs. You think niggas only know the three songs that came out on his album? He got B-sides that's solid.
I don't. I mean, I think he has his cult following. Everybody has. Every artist that has made it big has a cult following that will. You guys do fall into that cult following. No doubt about it.
I do not fall into Big Sean's cult following. That's not true.
You guys were there for the baby announcement. What are you talking about?
So is the rest of the world. I put on my Burberry shirt though.
Please go. I mean, y'all go look at an album, and if y'all pick a couple B-sides and convince me, I'm all for it. But the issue is,
I'm up for a challenge.
I don't think One Man Can Change the World is a B-side. If I heard it on SiriusXM, then it's not really a B-side.
What?
We're talking about
Big Sean. You can go to let's go back to his first album. His first album is
Finally Famous.
No, I'm just saying in terms of record by record.
No, Finally Famous.
I think it's the strongest album. To put in the verses.
Okay.
Either that.
Finally Famous?
Finally Famous or the one that came after that?
So the singles on Finally Famous was My Last with Chris Brown.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Probably coldest song on that album.
Marvin Gaye and Chardonnay, I guess we can say this. Actually, Marvin Gaye and Chardonnay isn't a single.
That is a fucking single.
It wasn't a single.
He had all the hop and artists.
It wasn't a single.
Are you kidding me? He had a video for that.
So don't tell you.
Don't tell me you love me.
It has to be a B-side.
It's a B-side, solid, and it's fire. It's a
fire
B-side.
Give me the melody real quick.
Don't tell you love me.
It's going to make it too hard for me. I wish you was ugly.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. That's hard. A B-side.
Memories with John Legend is on there.
That's would be the best. Memories. That's a single. He got a video. If you have a video, that's a single. Am I correct?
Okay. If you
are. Marvin Gaye and Chardonnay.
Has a video.
He paid so much money for that song.
I'll take that. I'll give you that. Lived His Life with the Dream is on there.
Melody, real quick.
Oh, shit.
I'm finally famous, and I'm rolling B-side. With the motherfucking
top.
B-side. So Much More is on there. That's the joint where that nigga damn near crying on there, talking about the city and how much he love it.
I don't expect you to relate to that one.
You don't get that. You don't feel that.
I'm not a bitch. I'm not a bitch. What do you guys expect, Dad? You guys know me.
You got some B-sides.
I'm just joking.
Look, you got some B-sides. You got Wait For Me on there with Lupe, which I actually like too.
Yeah, it's definitely a like.
It's a niche. They are there. Detroit didn't have any singles, I don't think.
I know. This is my issue, man.
Detroit didn't have any singles.
Huh?
The album Detroit didn't have a single on here.
The mixtape?
The mixtape, which hits. It hits on there.
Higher, 24K, Gold. How It Feel, Woke Up, Experimental,
Moolah,
100.
I mean, I think he is tied. On, he's tied for fourth out of his class. I'll give him that.
But that's what I'm saying. If we talking tied for fourth, we're not going to act like he's Ludacris.
Ludacris was first. I know. He's not.
When was he first?
That was hard as shit with the big hands. Oh yes. That, bro, Ludacris had a year, if not two. If Nelly had a year where he was the best rapper, Ludacris definitely had a year. 100%.
So 2001 was Word of Mouth with Roll Out, Move Bitch.
I don't know. who had a better year than Ludacris?
Area Codes was 2001.
This man got a whole movie called Hustle and Flow named after him. Ludacris. That guy, man. And Big Sean has never been in a fucking movie.
How we know that? We don't know that. Not about something. Look at this movie career. Yeah, he's in a movie somewhere.
But he has never been in a car in a movie.
Never been in a car
in a movie. All I'm saying is, man, don't do that. Just don't do that to Sean. But not in 2023. You
can't
not doing
here.
That.
You can't stand here and look at me and say that. I'm just saying. Big Sean was not next to Paul.
Okay.
What do you guys say?
I'm not doing this, bro.
You guys have to say back.
I just don't understand.
Bashan was next to Paul.
You know what? That's
even Wiz Khalifa got a song on that. Come on, now.
It's your opinion. Yeah.
This is the funnest part of
this. This is why we do this.
This is the fun part.
This is the troll. You just want to troll, nigga.
I'm not trolling. Nah, yeah, man. I'm just saying.
Trolling last week too.
Who?
With Cole. Just 2 weeks in a row, you trolled.
That was a troll, bro.
Trolling 2 weeks.
Wait, you went back to that chat? No, that's my guy. That's my guy.
Trolling two weeks.
You go back to that shit.
Wait, you went back to it?
I have not heard that song. This is the first day I played it.
Where is Cole? No, I can't diss J. Cole though. Like, that's my guy though, for sure. I knew him before the dreads. I was listening to his music before the dreads.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I mean, I like that. I just think we just need an album.
That might be the issue with Sean, that everybody in his class grew dreads, and he didn't.
Drake did.
Is Drake really in his class? Drake came out before them, though.
Nah, they're all the same class. They're all the same class, for sure. Drake, I mean, you talk about Drake, like, really being on. What's that, 09?
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Sean was definitely, like.
Sean was there.
Sean was there. That's, like, 2010, 2011. Right there.
There.
I'm done.
Thank you.
Take it away, gentlemen.
Jesus Christ. Another news. Shit. shit. You People dropped on Netflix. Did y'all watch it?
I did not. Can't say I have.
Okay.
But feel free to give me.
I'll give you a basis of it. Then y'all check it out. You know what I'm saying? So it's all the rave on Netflix. It's number one in America. But essentially, it tells the story of a It's by damn, what's this nigga name, bro?
Kenya Barris.
Kenya Barris, yes. It is by Kenya Barris, who also did Blackish, Grownish, Black as Fuck. Yeah. Okay. All those up in there. I think he helped write Mixed as Fuck too, which was also a show for like a season or two.
Yeah.
But yeah, he's pretty solid. he's pretty solid. But the movie is essentially about...
That's like stretching coke. Sorry, go ahead.
He got off. Yeah. No, that nigga can't be getting off, yeah. Boy. Fly-ass dude, too. Black as Fuck is funny as hell. Like, that's a really funny show, because he, like, got a little more...
leeway.
Yeah, he had a little more on Netflix to turn up a little bit. You know, Black-ish was like, you know, that shit was on TV. You know, he couldn't really... Netflix, he got off. But anyway, so this movie essentially is about a mixed couple that gets together, Lori London and Jonah Hill. They end up getting together, and their families have a hard time accepting each other in a very comedic way. Shit hits the fan, and then shit all comes back together at the end. That's essentially the gist. Very lightly, because y'all ain't seen it yet, I'm just going to give a couple things. One, I love the fashion sense in this movie. I think Kenya does a good job of embracing our culture when it comes to like how he makes his characters dress. It was fire as hell. Every fit, I'm like, damn, where'd Jonah get that from?
Jonah, yeah, I was about to say. Yeah. Except for that little tie-dye shit he had on.
The suit? Oh, so you seen it?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I seen it.
Oh, you watched it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay, so we're here. All right.
Yeah, he had the little tie-dye shit on.
The little tie-dye fit?
Yeah.
Yeah, I couldn't get that off. Not right now, but I seen what he was going at. The jokes was like, you know.
Had to match, yo.
Bro, it was nasty. It was like a joke that was set up before that, too. Like, yo, as long as you don't wear, like, as long as you're not buying a tie-dye sweatsuit, the next frame is not going to tie-dye sweatsuit. But it was like, I will say it was written to appeal to us. However, it was, like, overwritten to appeal to us to where I didn't, like, you know how they write some shit to make it seem like that's how we talk? But it's almost like, niggas don't talk like that for real in context.
Yeah.
I felt like that when I was watching it. So a lot of parts of it was a little cringy to me.
Yeah.
Or like a real like laugh. I probably really laugh maybe twice. The rest of it was like chuckles. You know what I'm saying?
Because
like it just wasn't like, I don't know. The shit that niggas would deem, it's probably mad people white people who watch this. Or, you know, and they might have thought this shit was hilarious. But for me, it's just like, I don't know. This shit just not funny. Like, it just wasn't.
Yeah.
The jokes was just, like, too far trying to be culturally in tune for, like, to where you, like, no one says this. Or, like, no one does this like this. Like, they had a Drake bit in there. And, like.
Yeah.
That was, like, cringy. It was, like, yo, relax. Like.
Yeah.
And it ain't even, like, I'm caping for my guy. I mean, fuck these niggas. But, like, you know, it's just, like, weirdest. We joking about Drake for 3 minutes, 4 minutes. Like, he's the whole dialogue.
And it was even, like, the way that. They compared the albums was just like not even like
it was, bro. That great. Yeah, it was just kind of trash. Like,
and I didn't like Eddie Murphy's
character. You like his character?
I liked his character. I just didn't like the fact that like it was
I can see what you're saying. What else you even saying it?
Huh?
I said I can kind of see what you're saying. What else you even saying it?
Like the way he was represented.
Mm-hmm.
Is it a shot to the nation or is it like,
yeah,
you know what
like,
I mean?
Like,
it was like,
yeah.
It was like, oh yeah, they be claiming the nation, but they really be fake.
Yeah.
That's how there's a point in the movie where you could perceive it as that. And this is like,
when he was talking to his brother and shit, which is Mike Epps,
which is a fool.
He funny as hell.
So but Lauren London acted her ass off.
She did great. But the tough part was for me is like, this was a so unlikely couple that I felt like I couldn't see it in real life. Even how they portrayed them in the movie, like I think they might have kissed in the movie one time.
Yeah.
Like throughout the whole movie. Even as a couple, they didn't look like a couple. Like
neither did Eddie and Nia.
Neither did Eddie and Nia. They looked like they were restrained.
And she didn't look like their daughter.
Yeah, not at all. Yeah, but
Eddie
and Nia Long made Lauren London and Taco from Future. From I Future.
What?
Yeah. All this shit was just
interesting.
I get a whole
and then
thing.
Taco and Lauren London are
brothers. Brother and sister. So like, I don't know. All in all, it's not a bad movie. It's star-studded as hell. Yeah. Even like, I forgot the dad played
David Duchovny. He was in Californication. Great show.
Yeah.
If you go back, but yeah. And
the mom was in some shit too.
She's in Veep on HBO.
Yeah. Everybody was there. It was star-studded for sure.
100%.
But all in all, if I gotta rate the movie, I'm probably giving it like a C.
Oh, boy, was in that. That was what Charlamagne.
Who?
Andrew. The comedian. It was just with Eric.
Oh, the dude from Dave?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Not that one, Schultz, the other one. Schultz.
Andrew Schultz.
Andrew Schultz.
Yeah, yeah, he was in there. He was like his homeboy.
He wasn't even had no real role. Like, it was one of the, so you know niggas had Brad because they had everybody in there. But I don't know. I'll probably get a whole movie a C. Like, if I had to rate it, I'd probably give it a 7, 6.5. Like, it really wasn't it for me. Like, I would never go back and watch that movie.
No.
If I did, I would do it just to, like, solidify the styles I saw to try to go buy them. Because the fits was fire.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
I'll have to add it to the list, though. We'll add it to
check
the
it
list.
Out. How you feel, Darryl? How was it?
I give it a... It was cool. Like, the ending wasn't really that that believable.
My nigga.
Yeah.
The ending was bullshit.
I really enjoyed The Last of Us this weekend, to say the least. Yeah. I would go watch you people, because I think there is an education piece there. I think the mom really acted her ass off.
I did agree with that.
The mom acted her ass off. Jonah Hill's, to a point of a degree, it was uncomfortable, and, like, it got to the point where, like, okay, Lauren Linden called her out, and it made it. It was good. It was a good point, and I think that the movie was not made for us.
It wasn't.
Yeah.
There's no way. No. There's no way it was.
Well, I appreciate the insight, because I really got, like, I mean, I got the notifications, like we all did, that it was coming out or whatever, but I really had no intention of watching it, so...
Yeah,
just watch for the education check piece and see what's going on, and I'll report back. Yeah. But I really wasn't going to. So thank you.
Definitely appreciate check it out.
100%, man. In other news, we had some games this weekend.
I was about to say.
Yeah.
We got some champions. We got a Super Bowl coming up.
Joe Shiesty versus Patrick Mahomes.
Yeah.
Jalen Hurts versus Nick Purdy and Josh Johnson.
and the coach and the kicker
and Christian McCaffrey play quarterback too.
Yeah,
y'all see that throw?
Yeah, and of the first row of fans, everybody was in that bitch.
Bro, it was.
Yeah.
I actually missed watching both of the games because I was.
Oh, you was over there.
I was at the event, but
yeah,
got to catch the end of the Chiefs and Bengals game on the radio, like on the way back home.
Okay.
But yeah. I mean, I don't really care who wins. There's teams I wanted to win, but it is what it is. I ain't got no money on any of them.
Facts.
I didn't bet this weekend. I might throw a little parlay on the Super Bowl just because it's the Super Bowl. But
who you getting a dub to?
Eagles.
Eagles for sure. I ain't gonna lie. Them niggas probably over a bunch.
Patty Mahomes about to fall short a couple hundred again.
Sauce to deliver.
I'll take Patrick Mahomes just because of Andy Reid.
I'm taking
Andy Reid as an X factor, not nobody on their team.
But 2 weeks ain't enough time for that nigga to get right, bro.
I mean, all he doing is ice bath. Like, he did that with 1 week.
That was the only play he had on his feet. That's the only run play.
Did you see the way he was like
limping to the sideline?
Crazy, bro.
That nigga limped fast as hell.
But if their defense show up, I mean. I don't know who's stopping that A.J. Brown and Jalen Hurts connection.
It's a vibe, bro. Them
you got Devontae Smith on the other side.
Bro, them Eagles is playing different, bro.
They got Goddard.
Oh, yeah, the tight end.
Mm-hmm.
Goddard, Miles Sanders. He's on my fantasy team this year. Yeah.
How do you do?
Got me some bread.
Yeah.
Which I have not seen yet.
Oh, we said
another weekend. Another weekend. We're still no money. We're still in drought, folks. We are still in drought. We will update you next week.
Got an installment plan set up.
Not an installment plan.
I didn't say payment plan. Set up.
Installment plan yeah, for my winnings is sick.
Crazy.
Yeah, but no, shout out to that boy Jalen, though, man. I was just looking at, they just been having like stories about, like, I mean, everything that nigga overcame from, like, that nigga got benched in a championship game. Alabama.
Yeah.
Went to Oklahoma, teed up. Second year?
Third year?
Yeah. Third year, that boy in the bowl.
He is.
Kudos to him.
And two is on concussion protocol.
Once again.
Ain't it crazy? Ain't life crazy?
Once again. Yeah, so you got boy this week, or your boy this weekend? He get fouled or he didn't get fouled?
Oh, yeah, he got fouled.
Got fouled?
That was a nasty foul. I ain't gonna lie. He did get fouled.
He got fouled.
He got fouled.
Obvious. Yeah.
No, he should have dunked that bitch is what he should have did.
No, nah, that is what I also
Yeah, he should have dunked it. But
instead of bullshitting. But
I mean, refs did their job. He did his job. It was the same play that they ran with Paul George, if y'all look at the play.
Mm-hmm.
About 2011, I think, playoffs.
Against the Heat. Or game 7. Heat Pacers.
And I think there's 3 seconds left. Same play. Same exact play.
Yeah.
And but he beat Paul George to the rim by a lot.
Yeah.
See the nigga losing a step.
I will say,
nigga's 40.
Patrick Beverly really is one of my favorite players. That boy brought the camera out to the refs, bro.
He brought the camera out. I was crying.
I was like,
and they
yo,
teed him up. Yeah.
He is really that guy. Yeah. Like, yeah. Like you need a Pat Bev on your team.
As much as I don't like Pat Bev, don't get me wrong, I can't stand Pat Bev. But like, when he in your corner though, oh yeah, that's an asset. That's an asset.
It's the best teammate to have, man.
I was like, yo.
That nigga brought the camera out talking about, it's a foul. It's a foul.
Did you see it? I'll show you. Man, that was hilarious. Man.
Sports has definitely been funny this past week.
That was hilarious.
100%.
Been a great time. Been a great time looking at that shit.
Yeah.
Man. Shit. I feel like it was more TV. I wanted to talk to y'all niggas.
So we got BMF. We got The Last of Us. Y'all don't watch that one. Y'all watch.
Gotta watch Last of Us.
Last of Us is one to watch. Y'all got to check out.
BMF, we all got to watch that. Oh, you seen the last episode, didn't you?
I did watch the last episode.
Yeah, I seen it, yeah. All I seen was the that viral clip they got of the dad walking out of two different rooms and everybody was talking shit about it. Somebody's supposed to be on Tubi. Yeah,
I did see that.
It's like this shit is like a Tubi movie. So essentially, bro, the scene is like, I'm assuming it's the part where like Meech and him got to run because Lamar turning up. Yeah. So like, the dad, like, they in the house getting frantic, like, we gotta get out of here, we gotta get out of here. The dad walks in from, like, the left side of the screen, walks in, and then walks out. And then he comes back in from the right side of the screen. And niggas is like, hold on. Wait. Who edited this shit? Like, anybody catch this? Like, niggas is like, yo, this is like a Tubi movie. This shit's supposed to be. That's like good.
I read the comments under it, and they was like, man, y'all thought this show was, like, Power or something. Been telling y'all the show is mid, like based off of that scene. I was like, I wouldn't say it's mid, but
somebody definitely in that editing room drunk.
Yeah,
because
it reminded me of that Ray J clip when Ray J hat kept changing.
Oh yeah, that's hilarious. Yeah, man, but we gotta catch up on that. Like I was telling them off air, I think. Oh, and I said it. The Boys is fire.
Yeah.
Definitely got to keep watching. I know it's 3 seasons right now, so I'm at like season. Yeah. I'm in season 2, like episode 2 or 3. So
I still got to add White Lotus to the queue.
White Lotus. I got to watch season 2 of White Lotus. I ain't watched it yet.
Still got to add it to the queue.
I ain't watched season 2 yet. Yeah. Got to turn up on that.
We got Bel Air coming back out this month, February 23rd. Snowfall the 22nd.
You.
Yeah, you is back. That's
you
right.
You are beautiful.
My thing is why the TV want to drop? I mean, this is a good time for TV. It's winter. It's cold. It's ice. Mm-hmm. I sit in the house and watch TV.
Yeah, I can't wait for Saints Row. I mean, Snowfall to come out.
I'm scared for Snowfall to come out.
Yeah, bro. I'm nervous. That last season was tough.
These niggas. These niggas was in a cage with a tiger in the middle of L.A.
And you got me in a fucking cage with a fucking tiger.
What are we talking about right now?
Was it pretty wild?
You were in a residential zone.
And a head under a house in a crawl space.
Come on, man. Crazy. Come on. It's too much.
Crazy.
It went too far left for me, man. Yeah. Right there.
Still don't
right
got there. No info on how he got this woman either.
How?
And how he got her pregnant.
Where'd
at
she
that.
Come from? And she a cop, probably. I still think she a cop. But whatever.
Yeah.
Guess we'll find out.
And what happened to the girl that was next door to him.
Right. Right. Yeah. Yeah, shit just got left. That shit like playing, what's that game where it's just like Saints Row?
Yeah.
Where like shit just got futuristic. You start fighting aliens and shit. It's a whole different game. Yeah, that's that shit turned into. It's just some bullshit.
We got to kill these aliens.
Yeah. It's like, bro, hold on. We was gangs. Like the first one, we was gangs. This was GTA.
Why is he
like,
why is he holding the gun sideways to an alien? Like,
why?
You need precision, sir.
Is that a spaceship? Like, what are we doing right now? Like, yeah, man. Shit is different out here, man. Niggas bullshitting.
That's crazy.
It's really nasty. I ain't playing no games in a minute, though. I ain't going to cap. I really want to get back into it.
I just got a game for the PlayStation.
What you grab?
What did I just grab? Spider-Man, the Miles Morales edition, though.
Fire.
I had the original Spider-Man, which was super dope, but I just never played it. But since we got the new TV, I was like, maybe I need a new game on this. You know, like,
oh, yeah, that's how niggas start racking it up.
I can actually see the game. So we'll see what I get next, but no.
I'll be in there in a minute.
But yeah, I got that Spider-Man Miles Morales edition.
That's hard.
I played it for a little bit, like, last week, but I was about to get back into Warzone and all that, but it take up too much space on the, like,
it take up too much space. And mentally, bro, it's just like, that's a game you gotta play to, like, get good at it. Like, yeah. I feel like you have to, like, even with how them games is now, it ain't like you pick up two guns and you got two guns on you and a couple grenades and some flashbangs. Then you got a whole, like, eight, like, different things you can have on you. The guns is modded. Like, it's like, bro, I don't have the time.
Like,
and then,
like, when you don't play
shit
for, like, a while and then you get back into it, there's, like, there's new stuff in there.
They got new game. You can buy your players back.
Yelling at me in the headphones.
Yep. Yeah, let me get
yelling at me in the headphones. Like, who is JF Trey 5? Put your shit together, bro.
Drop your cash, bro. Drop your cash. You can buy
him
back.
Doing nothing with us.
Drop your cash. You got so much cash.
Where's our
teammate
at?
When did I get money? When do we start getting money in this game?
What can I buy?
Yeah.
Where's the store?
Yeah, right. Where's the store? Where's the store? It's crazy.
Help.
I'm going.
Help me.
They're like, is that little case over there? I'm like, what the fuck is that?
What do I use my money?
Yeah.
Like, what do I get?
You could go get an airstrike. Go buy an airstrike.
Go buy an airstrike.
I'm like, nigga,
you black son of a bitch.
I'd be like, why? That nigga be having to show me grace and shit. I'd be like, why? Chill, bro. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, chill, bro. Bro. Don't come at me like that.
I don't know this, man.
Hey,
you know?
Not too much on me.
Not too, you feel me.
Yeah.
But that Spider-Man dope. I ain't gonna lie. I run to my little homie's crib every time I gotta watch him, and I turn that bitch on ASAP.
Really?
Yeah. Like,
solid.
Oh, it's good. Them out there. I didn't beat that shit on his game. He be having to start a new shit.
Yeah.
I'd have beat it.
You got past that level?
Yeah, I
know.
Yeah, he look dummy. Yeah. Stupid.
Cool thing about it is,
it's cool if I play now? No, let me get past this next
let
one.
Me get next.
Go ahead, man.
The cool thing is, it's like the open world. So, like, you don't even really got to do the actual missions.
Yeah.
Swing around that bitch and just fight people on the street or do the little side missions all day if you really wanted to.
Yeah.
That's the best.
Yeah. That's true. It is true.
I love it. I love it, man. So,
good story.
Get some music.
Let's do it.
All right.
I'm ready.
So this week we had a release from Yachty, Lil Yachty.
Yachty.
Dropped a tape this week.
He did.
Yeah.
Yes, he did.
What are y'all thoughts?
Well, let's start here.
Uh-oh. Why you say it like that? I don't like that energy.
I loved it. I loved it. I really did. I listened to it throughout the weekend. I got no bad. I really did enjoy it. From start to finish. I think there was maybe one track with him just talking. I think it was like whatever, the failed or something. I don't know the name, but off the top of my head. Let's see if I can find it real quick. Anyways, this album was good. Like I said, it felt like I wish I was listening to Tyler, the Creator, back when Igor dropped and like some of those older albums. Then to really like, now I want to go back and listen to something like that to kind of have a better appreciation. Like, I feel like I feel like my music palette essentially has grown, and now, like, I can respect this album a little bit more. But, like, when Igor or something like that was a little bit out there, like, from the artist dropped, I was like, eh.
Yeah.
I don't know. But hearing this from Yachty, I really liked it. Like I said, pretty much from start to finish. It's just something that you can put on, not really think about, like, the words too much or any of the bars or the lyrics. Honestly, good cleaning music, good working music. I really enjoyed it though. Start to finish. That's my early takes on it.
Okay.
It's in rotation. I mean, 31 days, this album of the year for me. 31 days in. So
31 days in. That's it.
All right. All right.
You say we only 31 days in, so it's bound to change. Yeah. But right now, seeing how ain't that many albums came out.
No, I ain't gonna lie. I actually have to go spin this. I haven't spun this album. I didn't hear it yet. I was nervous, but then I kept seeing mixed reviews, and so I kind of just like, yo, I'm gonna let this little hype for it die out a bit. I'll give y'all a take next week for sure. I just didn't I didn't give any of it love, but I have heard same sentiments that you're saying where it's like it's alternative for real, for real.
Yeah.
So I'm interested to hear it.
Yeah, definitely. If you looking to hear some rap, that's definitely you're not. It's not that tape for sure. But if that's the lane that he's going down, and he's entitled to change, just like Childish Gambino did, and just like some other artists will flip to a whole different genre. I think it's a good effort. It's a B for effort.
That was another album too that Awaken My Love. Like when it came out, I was like, nah, this
how you feel.
This ain't for me.
See, I reacted to Awaken My Love.
We had it as well.
Yeah,
Yeah. I think it was one of my favorites of Childish.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I can see that, though. You do have to be in a space to receive an album like that. Like, mm-hmm. especially when you go from Childish, I believe his album before that really didn't have. What was before?
1994. Or 2005.
Or
2005.
The internet.
The internet. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you going from that to Awaken My Love is like night and day.
He had a couple on there. On 3005, that was kind of like.
Could get there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I could
it
see.
Was, it was a little bit. Especially with the internet, like. I don't know. He might have been above it or before his time on the internet, yeah. for real. Yeah.
But for Tyler, though, it was his album before Igor was a rap album, though, right?
Before Ego was. That was.
Goblin.
That was. No, nah, before Ego was Flower Boy.
Oh, sorry. Igor, Flower Boy. Sorry, I'm thinking of Goblin was his first
album.
You went
all the way.
Okay. All the way. Yeah. So we got Goblin.
Wolf.
Wolf, which was amazing.
And then I think Cherry Bomb was after that.
Cherry Bomb.
Which I love. That was like my favorite.
Flower Boy.
Flower Boy.
Igor. Igor had. Yeah.
Yep. Earthquake. All that shit.
That was very upbeat.
That was a beautiful album.
I would say contrary to Yachty. Yachty was very mellow.
Yeah.
Okay. So, all right. So, that gave me a little bit more to expect than that. I could see that. Yeah. And then we got shit from Tyler. Then we got a...
Flower Boy was different, though.
Call Me If You Get Lost.
Yeah.
Which I feel album. Like was a happy medium of a couple of those albums, to be honest.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, but he even says it himself. Like, I watched a couple of Tyler interviews where he said when Cherry Bomb dropped, he was, like, legit in search of, like, his sound.
Yeah.
Like, you can hear it. Cherry Bomb has like a rock sound on there. It has a slower jazz sound. It has him rock, like,
yeah,
rapping. It has the joint with Wayne and Kanye on there.
He got Wayne and Kanye on there, and then he switches from, I mean, he switches to rock, and then all of a sudden he's got Wanda from Boyz II Men.
Yeah, like, he's got, like, that one is like legit.
A fucking gumbo.
Yeah. And I loved it, though. It was heat.
Oh, it was good. No,
it was heat.
I don't think he has a bad album yet.
Yeah, I can agree. I don't think he really has. I didn't give Flower Boy no spins, though.
I think that's his best Wayne feature.
A lot of people say that.
Yeah.
I think Goblin was the album I gave the most spins to. Like, everything else was just like, okay.
Just kept going after that.
And yeah.
Eagle, Wolf has some, too.
Wolf is a great album. Wolf is so slept on. Yeah, Wolf he got some Pharrell beats on there. He got some shit.
He got Pharrell on there. Yeah.
The Party Isn't Over.
Yep.
Yeah. That's got some shit on that one. Yeah.
Wolf is nuts. Damn, Tyler Appreciation. That nigga's a go. Mm-hmm.
I think with this, sorry.
No, go ahead.
I think with this album, I think I watched the video. I don't know if y'all watched it too, but I think Yachty said he wanted to drop this album to be taken serious or whatever. Mm. Didn't want to be that SoundCloud mumble rapper or, you know, whatever, this, that, and the other that people were putting him in this box. So this was an album where, like, yo, I want y'all to start taking me serious as an artist, essentially. So
I saw that. I don't think of him like that. I think that he is, there's something amusing about his music. Like, but when you make it up with a song, like One Night,
mm-hmm.
And then you never transition to actual, like you have outlets like Coffin, or you have like singles that like, oh yeah, this guy can actually rap, but there's no consistency with that. And then you do come out with The Walk, like, or Poland. And it's just like, all right, so what do we do? And if it's up to you, like, it is what it is, but, like, don't ask for us to take you X if you're not going to consistently show that.
Yeah.
Because you want to be put in a class, like, Uzi makes it out of mumble rap. Uzi is the head right now, for me, personally. Like, pause. But, like, of those guys from the North, or whatever you want to call that rapper, because you got the Uzis, you got the Kodaks, you got the Young Boys, and that's, they're running it. From that standpoint, but if I'm Yachty, he's like the Ian Connor of rap. Like, you don't really know what the fuck he does, but he has his own lane.
Facts. Yeah. And it helps a lot of people. Like, he didn't got mad niggas there. I mean, you look at the 21 Drake album, where Drake literally said, like, yo, this album wouldn't be this album if you wasn't on it. So
yeah.
Yeah. You just gotta I agree. I was the same way. I always gave a lot of Yachty his respects, even for my earlier pieces. Like, I thought Yachty made really good music. So and then when he did the D to the A joint with T, I thought that was fire.
He's rapping.
Yeah.
Like, rapping.
When he did that whole Detroit tape, that was fire. Like,
yep.
I don't know. I always thought Yachty was.
Like, I was going to say, there hasn't been an album that I've been like, yo, like, I don't rock with this. Do I go back to them often? No. But, like, it wasn't like that I never disrespected them as an artist. Like,
right.
He puts out great or good music to me.
Yeah.
like there's other artists where I'm like, yo, no, like this isn't it. But again, it's still not like a consistency like in his sound. Like he puts out good stuff, but
right. Yeah.
But yeah, this album though, like I said, I really enjoyed it. Like I said, I think it'll be one that stays in rotation. I mean, I hope it does, and I hope it gets the love and recognition. Obviously, I don't know what sales will be like next week, but
yeah.
Yeah, I don't know what sales will look like either. I ain't gonna lie to you, but yeah.
We don't expect much. But I don't think that's where Yachty makes his money. I mean, he's an influencer for a generation.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
That's true.
Yeah. With that being said, man,
anybody else drop?
Nothing worth mentioning, man. I don't think we get anything until quarter one.
Yeah, niggas don't drop anything.
Ray Shremmer dropped some stuff, man. Daniel Caesar dropped one.
Boss did announce the album.
Yeah, I saw that. Yeah. He don't deserve it until I hear it.
I thought Boss dropped, or did he just drop a single?
He just dropped a single, but he announced the album yesterday or something.
Bro, we having a Boss pod that day. We're going crazy.
Pod?
Bro.
I did listen to Too High to Riot the other day.
Oh, my God. Oh my gosh! Don't even.
Too high right. Oh my gosh!
I never to move sight. Got my eyes on her. Too much to say.
I like wasn't hit back then, but going back to it,
you see. Do you see? Although you may not agree, do you see the lane that I could say when? Nah, I feel like Boss might be better than Jid.
Yeah, I got you.
Because Jid is a better especially with the last shit. But like at the time, all I was grading was the Leonardo DiCaprio, like those shits, and it was DiCaprio. Just like fuck. Like this is all I got from. Jid, now with Jid dropping this, Boss has to come out with something. It's too much at stake. Yo, Boss is cold, dog. And I'm not fucking around. Wayne, I promise you, bro, you go back to these last two tapes.
I gotta spin it, bro. I'm not a Boss fan. I don't listen to Boss like dog, that. I just don't give him the time.
It's just, you gotta fucking remove Cole from that shit. When you remove Cole, you be like, oh, this nigga breathing on his own. He's good. And then you start being like, damn, this nigga's like really Geechee. Like, you can fuck with his music. Right. He really.
I'm gonna do it, man. I'm gonna do it.
Did you listen to the Milky Way album?
By who?
Milky Way?
Boss?
Yeah.
I listen to a single Boss album. I listen to Boss singles every now and then. Like, if he's on a feature, I'll spin it. I never thought he was bad, though. Like, I think he holds his weight on everything I've heard. It just never was, like, enticed to, like, go and, like, let me go spin Boss. You feel me?
Yeah. And, like, even on Costa Rica, I didn't like his verse because it was, like, so. I got it, but it was just, like, demons, they follow me deep in the dark. Niggas got problems with being a boss. It just, like, the way it started, it wasn't, like.
I didn't grab you enough.
Is it because. Home, but I hear all the talk.
Is it because he.
This nigga had 45 seconds on the fucking song. That's one point. But yeah, go ahead, Mark.
No, but even with that, is it something where you would say, like, yo, as an artist, his creativity kind of like wasn't there in that?
You remember when Cold Summer came out with fucking.
Cold Summer.
Cool Summer. Or what
Cruel
was it?
Summer.
Which one? Cruel Summer.
Cruel Summer comes out. Shit. And you have every good music artist on here, and all that Kid Cudi gets is Creepers.
Yeah.
And Creepers is a great song, but it's just such a fucking outlier compared to the rest of the album. And you're like, what the fuck is, like, yeah, super dope song. It's actually a really cold song, Creepers is, but like, what is this doing on Cruel Summer? Yeah. Am I right with
that's how it felt with
Boss. It's just like, damn, bro, like, he's got songs on there, don't get me wrong, but like, it's just like, damn, like, he don't fit on this type of shit.
Right.
This man singing all of a sudden, like, I ain't heard no rap verse from Boss in a minute. He's doing R&B on fucking Co-op.
Right.
So I'm looking forward to it. Hopefully it's bars.
Mm.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Talk your shit. We will see.
We'll see.
We definitely will. My nigga got passionate over Boss.
We'll see.
It's not passionate over Boss, but this is how I get with these artists that's like, that actually release music consistently.
No, I feel
but
like
Boss doesn't.
What's wrong with passion?
Nah, man, because it's
just
like,
saying, that's good.
Y'all get on me about Sean, and it's like, man, like, for real, bro. Know. Like, nah, bro, because I cry over this shit. Dang, you can't even let me get to the cry. I cry over this shit, for real, dog. Like, you gotta let me get to the point where I'm about to cry, dog. At least let's set this shit up.
Jesus Christ.
There is one thing in the music world that I have to speak on quick.
Hold on, why are you starting it like that? Let me
rest
adjust
in peace.
The camera.
Rest in peace.
Why?
Okay.
Is Blueface and Krishan being pushed down my fucking news feed, my timeline,
I understand.
And the internet. I know I can block the words. I know I can block the words, but I just don't understand the obsession with these two human beings. Get them off of my motherfucking timeline. I don't care.
They treating them like they're Bobby and Whitney. Oh, like, for real.
Stop it.
Like, they got that much talent. No disrespect, bro. But, like.
No, it's like every time I get on Twitter. Again, like, I know I can block the words. I can do that easily. But for some reason, I feel like they still going to pop up somewhere.
Still. To this day.
Shout out to Deontay. Y'all going to see that Creed? Sorry. I have nothing to say about this, dog.
No, I will say they are feeding a very unhealthy relationship. Yeah, and bro. The media is, bro, niggas watching, bro.
I just don't get it, though.
What happen when you watch?
Bro, so many, I ain't seen nothing on Laurie and Damson.
Who want to watch that? That's a pimp and a simp. And it ain't the way y'all think it is.
That was
a good one. You know what I'm saying?
On fast break, bro. You just
that was it.
Three.
That was
I don't
it.
Know what the fuck is your problem, but you made
that was
it.
A half court shot.
Yo.
That was Logo
man.
Lillard right there.
That's a pimp and a simp.
You thought
bro.
The shot clock was out, didn't you?
I did. I swore it was. I just
gonna
threw
cut
it up.
You. If you missed.
I really just threw it up.
If you missed.
I really just threw it up.
If you missed.
Hey, man.
Nah, but that's all I have to say, man. Like, it just.
I agree.
It was on my heart, man.
And I'm tired of watching them scrap, bro. Now, what I will say is,
right,
when
why
I
you
did
putting
see,
hands on a woman, though? Like,
when I did see Blueface knock her dad out, that was comical.
Yeah.
I did laugh. That was. I'm not even going to lie to you. Her dad tried to sneak him, mm-hmm. missed. Like Blueface cleaned his clock.
Blueface like 6'4", ain't
he? Bro, 6'4", yeah. This a whole athlete. Like, what are we doing? But, like, yes, all in all, very toxic. I fed into it for 5 seconds. I stopped. But, like... I think they just dropped a music video and they like got married in the music video. Like some shit like that just happened.
Yeah, they put that Drake.
They really did.
I have nothing to say.
I have nothing to say that either.
That's it.
I understand
your frustration, bro. Yeah. But you got to limit your, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah, it's just
everything is diet, dog. Like,
I got another thing on my heart, too.
You ever have wheatgrass?
Damn, nigga. We in a confessional? Go ahead. Yeah. What else? What else you got, Jay? ISO. ISO.
So at work, right?
This your Brian Milwaukee game when he beat the scoring record. Go ahead.
This is Brian Foul game. It was a foul.
What? No. Yeah.
So at work, right?
Yeah. It's just not fair.
All right.
It's just
so
not
at work, right?
Yeah.
Dude,
what about it?
Dude, come in. He's waiting for like our owner for a meeting, right? Okay. I say he's on his way. Can I get you a water or anything? He says no. Like I'm good.
Okay.
And I'm like okay. Like,
respectable.
He'll be here in a minute, but you know, like I asked, make sure see if he wanted water.
Hey.
I go back to my regular work, but I see everything happening. Someone else asks if he wants a water. And he says yes.
Maybe he got thirsty in that minute, though.
How you feel about that, Jay? That charged Jay up. Hey, Jay. You threw a water at his head.
It just felt a little like.
Yeah, you felt it?
It felt a little weird.
Yeah. I get it.
You know we don't let niggas touch the purifier.
I was like,
Nah, you did.
I don't know why I picked it up, but I did. It was just like, oh, so now you want a water.
Yeah. How quick an instance is
it? It was like, I kid you not, 2.5 minutes, which I guess you can get thirsty in 2.5 minutes.
I say this.
Yeah, when I ask him, like, oh, you must have got thirsty there.
I thought about walking past him, like, oh, how's the water?
I say this. I have been in scenarios where I said no the first time and yes the second time.
Yeah,
I have
pressure.
Been there. Okay. Even like AK Ricks. Like AK Ricks, for instance. These motherfuckers ask you if you want something to drink every 40 seconds. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I've been in there. As soon as I walk in, no, I'm fine.
Here's my new hack, bro. I don't go there. I go there. I order online and I pick it up. Like it's for food.
Mm.
I don't fuck with that no more.
That nigga carry out at that bitch. That nigga carry out at AK.
I'll be in there. I'll be out in and out in 5 minutes, dog.
Can you tell me why you carry out at AK?
Uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Uncomfortable. I understand we're in West Michigan, which is like Bible Belt and very, very
conservative.
But man, it's like the situation is I get to look at my leisure because I feel bad when I'm telling them to like bring stuff to this. And I don't know why I feel that way. I deserve exactly what I'm paying for. But the carry out option is amazing because very similar to you going to Stella's carry out and you're in there for 5 minutes. It's so nice.
Yeah.
Plus you can go through. They got hella sales on there, bro. I walked out with some.
I can see that.
Bro. On for real, $45 for some $200 swim trunks.
Go crazy.
Nigga.
Go crazy.
Nigga.
Go crazy.
Two of them boys.
Swimming in luxury.
Oh, my gosh.
Speaking of clothes, another sidebar.
My nutsack didn't know what to do. Pause. Go ahead.
Did you see the OVO?
NFL? I did. It looks nice.
Drake bought a team?
I wouldn't buy it, though.
No?
No. It's just, there's fads. I think if it was like, if I was a real Green Bay fan, maybe I would get like the varsity. But like, anytime I got a big aisle on some shit, I ain't wore a big aisle on some shit since I was like 18, 19.
Y'all, you know, feel like saying? Y'all so past that past point? That.
I just am. I am a little.
You getting
past
the
that.
Fenty stuff? You getting the Fenty shirt?
The Fenty. Oh, the Super Bowl?
Yeah, the Fenty Super Bowl.
I don't know. I don't like that either. I think I'm over merch unless it's very well designed. And that's just the hard thing for me. Yep. I don't know. So we'll see. The Rihanna with the football and the arm, that's not terrible, but like, I don't know. I just don't like niggas knowing where my shit from. You know what I'm saying? If you make some merch to where it's just fire, everybody, but like, yeah, you can't really like pinpoint what this is,
yeah,
that's when I fuck with it. But if it's not, then that. Going back to that AC or the AK point, Ricks, though.
Yeah. Which is a luxury store in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Yeah. Only luxury store in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Shout out to Fitzgerald's.
And I'm probably going to have to bleep that out because of what I'm about to say. Okay. I be running them white motherfuckers around.
You don't care.
Darryl,
yeah.
I try on everything. Yeah. I make them go back and forth countless of times. When a pair of pants that I'm going to buy, I try it on my second time. It's sitting right there on that chair. I will run them up
do that shit,
around
King.
The whole for
you deserve
3 hours.
Do that shit, King.
For three. Snobby as hell. Do yeah, go shit, grab King. That fucking shirt, nigga. Go get that shirt off that fucking rack, boy.
Do that shit, King.
What's your name,
boy?
Rodney? Hey, yeah. Rick.
Yeah, yeah. Go give me a fucking water.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Water and whiskey. Bring that shit here.
No, it's not January anymore.
Yeah. So you know what the time it is.
I can't wait till I don't care. Bro. So what I hit, like.
I think I'm like born for the don't care. I'm the nigga that go to Chop House in jogging pants. Like, I'm here to take it all away.
Yeah.
Everything you thought you built, I'm here, nigga. I'm here, and I'm literate. I know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
I know all. I'm good.
Talk your shit.
But I'm about to
King.
Get off in all these little establishments, nigga.
I only do that with cars, bro. That's about it. Like, I don't do that with clothes. I just feel fucking like, I don't even like trying on clothes and shit like that.
Oh,
bro.
Yeah.
Like, for real. I'd be like, yo, give me a medium shirt. Give me this pant. Give me this. And if it don't fit, then it just sits in a fucking closet. Like, that ass. Because I'm so fucking, it's inconvenient. Yeah. Give me a medium shirt, give me this, give me that, I'm out of there.
I make a day out of going over there. Yeah. I make a day of it. I'm going to have a time in there. Y'all got snacks in this bitch? Go grab me them peanuts, nigga. Out the back.
Use that, I don't care. So I will say this, no flex, but I did the same shit with cars. Like, okay. I was not fucking around, bro, because I really am. Even at a point where, like, I feel like I shouldn't be getting something, that's the time where I really should go find something.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I should probably go touch something, 100%. Feel it. So I did that shit, bro, and I was like, I did three of them for cars that, one of them I know for sure that I couldn't even picture. Mm. I don't even know how to picture it, but do you feel it? The first one, it was nice little SUV, and I was like, oh, this is cool, whatever, whatever. And then I got into the electric vehicle, and I was like, oh, this is sick. This is a lot better than what I'm in right now. And it was the Porsche Taycan. Then I went to the GT3, which is a gas-operated vehicle. I haven't driven a gas shit in a minute. And I tell you, niggas, like, I have never been blown away. And I also have never had, like, holy shit, like, this is what I'm never going to feel nothing like this again. Porsche made me make the best car ever, point blank. Damn.
Could you see it on the... on the people's face, like,
I don't even. It was me by myself. They let you take the car by yourself.
Okay,
which is
high. I know how they played it over at Porsche.
Yeah, it was 100% cool with it. But I've been putting that shit has been on my vision board for like 6 years. Mm. The Porsche GT3, like, which is the fastest at $214,000 worth of. That's just shit that fucked me up. Like, when you see somebody, I heard that nigga Andrew Tate said it. When you see somebody and driving a $200,000 car, and you be like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
This person driving a car that is, and they be at AK Ricks, right? They be in a parking lot. You pull up to AK Ricks in a parking lot, bro. You seeing something?
Oh yeah.
Most times, I should say.
Or I mean, on the low end, you might see Escalade.
You may see something like but like I pulled up one time and I saw the old, like some type of Volvo, and the dude that got in there was like, he mentioned it while we was walking in, and he was like, "Yeah, it's my son's car. He's 16 years old." I was like, "All right, that makes sense."
Yeah,
because the nigga walked out with a brand new tux. I was like, "Yeah, you just spent $7,000 on this fucking tux. What the hell? Like,
what you doing in this motherfucker?
Something not good here. You spent $7,000 on a tux. Nigga, you in a $2,500 car. Anyway, with that being said, bro, Porsche makes it. Porsche guys." Condos in Miami. I'm not sure if y'all knew that.
I did hear that.
Yes. And your key is your car. You drive it up into your, and then it sits in your unit.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, niggas getting money out here.
Nice. That's nice.
Getting money for real. I'm not,
I can't even lie to you and look at me like it's like,
no,
like it's
really hard. Money
it's,
out here.
It is hard, but like what I find is that these guys, they focus on these guys and girls, they focus on my business, whatever I do, my family. I will not gossip with you at work. I will not talk shit with you at work. I will not do it. I will not get distracted at work. I focus on this, and this gets me to my family. Then to my family, I not only go get dinner with them from 7 to 9, but then I jump back on, and I'm back online at 9 p.m., and then I go to bed. And that's the shit that I'm like, that makes sense.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, yeah, I don't know. It's super dope.
That shit different.
Kind of.
I mean,
to a certain degree, like when we don't know.
Yeah. And it's like, yeah, we don't know it. One. And then you just look at the levels of like, there's a part of me that's like, there's a battle where it's like living versus like how much money can you bring in?
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, you're going to have to sacrifice it. Even when it's like, you get to the point where like you're off, your money makes money for itself. You still have to work. Like, and I think that's the, I forgot where I heard that at, but it was like, nigga, you're still working. Like, you just might not work as physically, or it just might be, you're more so consulting or whatever that looks like. But like,
still
like you said, there's niggas that's like, they working all day. They taking the time to go with their fam for a minute and they back at work again before they go to bed. And then they go to bed and they wake up at 5 a.m. and 9
p.m. to 12. Like, yeah, it makes sense, bro. Like,
and it's like, the question is just like, do you want that? Because if you want that, then you'll get that. Like, you'll get it if you want that.
100%.
But is that the life you want?
Yeah.
And then you have to make your decision based upon that, I think.
I think that's fair.
That's all it is.
Yeah.
Because, like, for me, I know I'm a very much an experienced person. I would rather do more experiences in life and take whatever pay cut that looks like and be okay with that. I'm content.
Yeah.
But the next thing might be like, bro, I want my money touching the before I die, and I don't care what it takes to get there. It's just all up to you. I think it's all, but you, regardless for both of them, you got to work. Yeah, yeah, but regardless for both of them, you got to work. The experiences won't happen unless you do the work to get to those experiences. It's the same way.
It's 100%.
Yeah.
I'll tell you, like, me personally, what I face and what's morbid as fuck, bro, is like my biggest fear. You talked about earlier in this pod, you said worry, like 100%. So I have this question always, is selfless or selfish? And I think of selfless as I want to provide as many opportunities for motherfuckers like look like me or don't look like me, but just fuck with me as possible. And if I don't, if I can't do that, then I'm being selfish. And what I mean by that is for me and my motor and to know that, and to know that I'm okay with staying up to X and understanding I wake up and I don't need to check Instagram. I could just jump on the computer at 6. I could literally, I know that I have to provide. God put me on earth to provide opportunities. And it's selfish of me to say I my capacity and my potential is only this because I'm only working until my bills are paid. But if I don't think about what other people's bills, their families, their opportunities, and what a 10-year spectrum looks like for me to help them out in their lives, I'm an asshole. And I think about that. What gets me is like, fuck, like people around me, but then I'm like, damn, like there's a lifestyle that my parents haven't seen, my brothers haven't, like I think about that shit so frequently, so I talk about it because I'm not manifesting on it. I don't need braggadocious shit. I could get off, but I'm not that guy because I don't need that. But I do need to produce those opportunities to others because it's like, no, my nigga, like you can go hop in a fucking GT3 right now just by calling and shooting a fucking text, and it's keyless entry. You don't even got to talk to nobody. That's a $250,000, bro. You driving around $250,000. How could you not feel like that? How could your mind not be exposed? Yeah. You drive a Mustang again. Like if I went back to the Mustang, it's like not going to do shit for me. Don't give me a tweener. Like it's just, it's just a fucking Mustang. So that's where I get. No, it's almost like selfish or selfless. Like if that's I do not shit. Provide this many opportunities, then knowing what I know and also being able to read books and all that shit, like it's just like fuck. Like I'm selfish. Like that's how I feel. Right. But that's not. That doesn't correlate to everybody because it's your life.
Yeah. Right.
My point is that.
Yeah. That makes sense.
100%.
Real spiel.
Real spiel.
Shit.
Selfish or selfless. I like that.
That's my new album and shit. And I've been working on it. You know what I mean? Selfish or selfless.
Oh, shit.
But when I'm with you, I want to see myself less.
All right. Look, let's cut these and we're going to talk wine and then we get out of here.
Let's get it. Man, let's get this thing started. We didn't even introduce the wines, but here we are. I got the Mathiasen 2019 Merlot, Phoenix Vineyard, so single vineyard Merlot. Shout out to my guy Derek, also fam of the pod.
Shout out to Derek. Yes.
Hooked me up with the bottle. I got another bottle from Mathiasen coming at some point soon. But let's get into a little bit of these notes on the Merlot. I had this wine back in Napa, had to get another bottle. It was tasting a little bit more of like fresh red fruits when I had it back last March. Obviously, it's been had some time in the bottle. This bottle in specific. Did throw an aerator on there, so I do get like some like hints of red fruits. But kind of moving more into like blackberry, kind of like dried plum, a little bit of smoke and leather notes. But still a pretty fire bottle. Moderate acidity, just kind of like light on the body too, which Merlot in general tends to fall kind of light. But I would go 9. I really love this Merlot, and I don't drink Merlot, but that would be my rating for
that boy going high.
Man, this is some fire Merlot. I'm not gonna lie to you.
I love it. I was close to getting a Merlot for this pod, man. I want to say shout out to the brand Almadi out of Spain. I feel like the podcast hasn't given enough love to wines from Spain at this point Spanish in time. Wines? This is a Grenache varietal, full bodied wine. I'm liking the red that color that this wine has on it, giving raspberry and some cherry feels on this one. 14.5%. We've enjoyed this wine during this podcast. I'm gonna give this an 8.2. I'm looking forward to having more wines from Spain on this podcast. I will devote to doing that this year in 2023.
They're pretty affordable too. I ain't gonna
yes lie to you. We have had Grenache on here, so yeah, let's get to it. It's been good. Ranger. Bet.
I got the McBride Sisters. We've had it a couple of times. Black Girl Magic Riesling. It's always a go-to. I feel like this is a safe bet every time. Like, you know what you're going to get.
Shout out to the
McBride Sisters. You can't go wrong with it. The Black Girl Magic Riesling. Again, this is a 12% alcohol content on here. I would say it's a pretty sweet Riesling myself. I definitely think this is something that's, I mean, it's crisp, it's fresh, light. I feel like this is definitely something if you're having a party or a get together, you can bring this McBride through, and it's for those sippers who are just weaning off the Moscatos, the Diastis, you know what I'm saying? Like, you're starting to like finally kind of move forward in your palate a little bit, or just a little experimental on what it tastes like. It'll still be close enough that way for you to feel comfortable, but you know, you can talk your shit a little bit. You're drinking a Riesling now.
I love it.
You know what I'm saying? So McBride Sisters, the Black Girl Magic Riesling 2020. I'm gonna give this a 8.5 out of 10 every time they come through. I love it. So
solid. Yeah. Let's get it. This is episode 125 of Music in the Bottle podcast.
Thank y'all for rocking.